Hello. Welcome to Manyland. So Manyland is this game where you can draw. You can draw sprites. So like I made this Mega Man sprite, and I made this Final Fantasy sprite. I also made this big monster sprite. But I'm a computer scientist, so that means I'm inherently lazy, and I don't like having to click around on sprites. I don't like having to do this. So you can draw your own sprites at any time, but this is a lot of work. Like, what if you want to fill this in? So, in order to avoid all this work, of course made a program to avoid having to click every little pixel there. Yeah, I'll close that. So I'll just show you the program. Here's the program. It's written in Go. Probably not idiomatic. I'm pretty new to Go. So I'm using exact screen coordinates here. So it's the base of the screen, basically a drawing window, the size of each of those pixels, the number of max pixels, or palette, what a gray palette looks like. And then here I load up a PNG file. I decode it to get its size. I open up the xDisplay. I use an xtest library I made. I get the screen. I make a click function where I can press a button and then release the button. I've got a color distance function, just Euclidean distance. I don't recommend Euclidean distance. Consider using HSV or YUV. Either one's better. I've also got a fine color algorithm that finds the minimum between two colors, returns where it is. And I also have a click palette method that works in a way that it will, here we go, create, click palette, will click one of these in the palette. That base thing is that pixel there, and then I also said these are 24 pixels wide of 19 pixels, so there's 19 of them there. Alright, so back to the Go. So I've got all those functions. Then what I do is I say for each pixel in that PNG, find the most similar color using Euclidean distance to our old color. Click that color on the palette. Move the mouse to the pixel location. Sleep a little bit. Click and sleep a little bit. And just keep doing that. So it's very simple. It tries to find the best color based on the palette you give it. I haven't had it automatically go find the palettes. That's a neat little minimization problem, but I didn't get around to that. So you're thinking, well, is it really that bad? Yeah, it actually is bad. So I'll show you what we can do. We can go into the GIMP, and we can draw a picture. So this is 19 by 19, and I'll draw that. So let's save that as projects, go Manyland. We'll call this one fuzz 1 PNG. Export it. Export. Okay, good. Now we're here. Change the size of this thing here. I'm going to go create. I'm going to say O, pick this creation. And look, I inherit this gray palette that I made. And I go run Manyland go fuzz PNG. Plus PNG. And there you go. It is moving my mouse around and it's drawing that image, which looks mildly inappropriate. I must have clicked that by accident. Can't see that. Just change that. Alright. So, we'll call this blob. And I'll go OK. Now I got a blob. I can draw it around. So that's not that interesting. But what I can do is I can go into here. And I can go open document. take my profile. See, don't I look pleasant? And then I can go image, scale image, 19 by 19, break it. Coast scale. Alright, this sort of looks like me. And then I'm going to change the image to grayscale. Right? And I go save. Or I go export. Go recently used. And I'll go A1 PNG. Alright. Then I can go here. I can go create. I press O. Take this in. Then I can go draw A1 PNG. And you can see that it chooses the pixels at the bottom, it chooses the color, and then it draws the bitmap. And you can see it looks sort of like I do. Or at least I used to. I have a haircut. Alright, so I'll go left. This. Look at this narcissistic display of bitmappery. Alright. Ooh, scary monster. Alright. So, that's pretty neat. We can also take other stuff in there. But, we can make pictures of other stuff. So I take the blob, and I'll put in, BPNG. So we could easily, with grayscale, draw the anti-alias text. So there's a B. Real exciting. Alright, so that was just a demo of what I've done to Manyland, and it's unstoppable. You can't really stop me from using instrumentation to control the mouse. So this is the kind of hack where you don't actually change their code, you just sort of probably irritate them by the fact that you're automating the use of the browser, and they have no control over that. So they probably don't like that. They're probably going to ban all this stuff. I'll probably clean it up so I save them time. Alright, well, that was my demo of Go, used to use xtest, and use it to basically draw bitmaps into Manyland, which is relatively pointless. I just want to show you what xtest looks like, and why I actually sort of like Go. Alright, so I copied a bunch of stuff from GUI test XS from Perl. And so I just kept the copyright header there. So the nice thing about Go is you can include C directly into it. So I provide build commands, like use package config for X11 and xtest. I provide include directives. And I provide this helper function for me. Gets a pixel off the screen. And I do that by going importing C. So basically the comment above, it sucks all that comment in, and it treats that as C. It's really easy to call C functions because you can just go C dot and the type, or C dot and the function name, and then give it its parameters. So here I open an X display, here I close an X display. I'm calling two C functions here, X sync and X close display. Here I get the screen, I get the default screen from X default screen using that display pointer, C. And you'll notice that everything's done with C. And then I pass it in a C integer. And I sync, and then I return the screen. To press a button, I call the xtest fake mouse button event. I pass in uints and ints and ulongs, and you basically just convert your types down, you run those conversions, and you call your C functions, and you can return. You can even return C types, so here I'm returning C int. Same thing for release button. The only difference is that this boolean is just an integer. If I want to move my mouse around the screen, I check to see that if I've got enough screens, and then I warp the pointer. And I can make another call, so x warp pointer, x root window, display, so I move the mouse around the screen. I can call usleep, just wrap that up real fast. I can also make neat types, and I can sort of use references to get values out of, say, C functions. So this is the cGetPixelColor, which I called at the top. So one nice aspect of Go is that I can actually do C programming in Go without a lot of work, and the build system handles it right there. Isn't that nice? So, things I like about Go, closures, calling C, things I don't like about Go, lack of generic types. Alright, thanks for your time. And don't take off the Manyland.